Well, good morning. We're heading off for another trip, so come along and join us. We're going to Leavenworth, Washington. So, good morning. We left home this morning at just a little bit before 5 o'clock. Or actually, no, maybe it was a little after 5 o'clock. I don't know. Anyway, but it's now almost 7:30, and we have stopped at this location. And if, let me see if I can swing back here. I'll have to open the window. Chris found a spot that he wants to get a picture of the mountain and this little house, this rundown house that's there. So the photographer is right there getting his photograph. And it's beautiful valley. That must be, is that good? Off in the distance, or is that? Not sure what mountain that is over there. And then I think this might be Adams over here, but I'm not sure. I'm noticing this. Let's see if I can do it. Beautiful, cute little farm or something. Hey friends, so I am standing on the balcony of our hotel room, which, let's see if you can see it. It's kind of small, but yeah, we have a balcony. But the best part is the view.
Yeah, that's our view right there. No joke. It just keeps going. Anyway, yeah. It's pretty fantabulous.
Okay, so I am standing on the roof, or the front balcony of the hotel that we're staying in. Here's the top balcony. Our hotel, and it's a foggy night, so the street lamps have that cool glow around them. There's this beautiful tree in front of the hotel. It's all lit up. And then as you look down the street, you can see that the town is lit up as well, although because of the fog you can't see very far, but it's beautiful.
You can go ahead. Go ahead.
This is the room where we are eating breakfast, our complimentary breakfast, by the way. And this is the view. Later on, there will be a trumpeter who will come out and play one of the traditional Austrian horns and stand up on the balcony outside. But in the meantime, we just sit and enjoy this. Sorry, go ahead.
Oh, you're all right.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. So we came down along the waterfront, and we stumbled across a fortress. This is the Blackbird Lodge. And it looks so amazing. Thank you.
one that puts sugar, water, cornstarch, fruit puree, and pectin. They cook until it reaches 230 degrees. Each batch weighs about 256 pounds, and it will take about 30 to 35 minutes for it to cook. When the candy is done cooking, they pour it out into a smaller kettle right here, turn the mixer on, pour all the nuts in there, and mix it together. They will then peel it over in front of the weigher, raise it up, and pour it out.
When it reaches the end, it should be full, and they hand put them into the boxes. Now the box that they are doing today comes to us as one piece. That means we pulled them by hand. Most of our other boxes come to us with two pieces, the blue machine wraps plastic on, and then heat seals. The last thing that goes through is the gray arm here. This is the metal detector. We just want to make sure there's nothing in the candy that shouldn't be there. Here's the end of the sticker needs to go on. This is where it is done, before the candy is put into a box and onto a pallet. We say a candy has about a 6-month shelf life. If you wish, you can put them in the fridge for about a year, or you could freeze them up to 2 years.
So, this is the original stove that they used to make applets and cutlets on. And this is the original kettle in which the first batch of applets and cutlets were ever made.
What do we got?
Applets and cutlets. Back in the 1920s. And some of the So here's the original founders. And then over here are some pictures of factory workers. In 1928, it says. So cool. So here's the Santa's Village to bake, eat your heart out with. Start at the very end and work our way down. I think it has a peanuts. Oh no, it's got a peanuts. There's a tree up there that has the lamp from Christmas Story. Wow, they even have the Empire State Building. I don't know if you can make that out, but incredible. I have to stop because Chris is taking a picture. That church. It's amazing. Very cool. Come around when it's coming out. It's Christmas morning again. We saw the ladies dancing. We just follow the light. Let's give thanks to the Lord above. Oh, it's the Frank Lloyd Wright house.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, that's one of his houses.
Yeah.
Hartley House. That's not his famous one. It's probably one of his famous ones.
And it's still going. The cemetery has a ghost. This one's cool. Toy Story. Oh wow, look at this Bee Sweet Shop. Oh, it's a delivery truck. And driver. A church. Oh, a carriage. Right? No. Oh, I guess it's just some bicycles. Oh, we've got a barbershop quartet. Fishing huts.
Glass is mouth blown from the highest grade of glass tubing, leaving a small opening in which the painter can insert the brush. These specially trained and skilled artists.
Phone booth. That's amazing. Oh, here's a camper.
The artist starts by outlining the subject matter, the traditional Chinese black ink, and a brush is fine.
And just in time, here comes Santa on the sleigh.
Prior to painting, the inside glass surface is etched.
That, actually, believe it or not, is the end. Of it all lit up, that'll be in the video, of course. There's more stuff down the side streets. They even have a Bavarian-looking hospital in town now.
You showed him that on the other video.
Okay. Anyway.
Starbucks.
That's the local equivalent to the convention center kind of thing. Well, everybody, we're done with our vacation. All we have now is the trip home. And we had an amazing time. Mm-hmm. I think we're a little tired just from being so busy as we, more busy than we usually are. So, but it's a good tired, a happy tired. And can't wait to get home and hug our people and sleep in our own beds. So, although the beds were pretty good at the Enzian Inn, we highly recommend it. So,
yep.
Anyway, well, Dankeschön from Leavenworth, Washington, and we wish you all a Frohe Weihnachten, which is Merry Christmas in German.
Auf Wiedersehen.
Bye.